What's up, everybody? It is Tuesday. I'm back. I got my coffee. And today we're checking out a song. It's an older song, about a year, 2 years maybe. But I hadn't heard of the artist until last night. So we're going to check it out. The artist is either HYD or HYD. It's HYD. I'm not sure how it's meant to be pronounced. And the song is called Chlorophyll. Before we get into it, a couple things. Please remember, I'm not a professional. I'm not a vocal coach. I'm not an engineer. I'm not going to be getting too into the weeds on production or anything like that. And don't be a dick. You know, I try to be thoughtful when I do these. And, you know, when I come into something cold, I don't know if I'm going to like it or not. But I try to be respectful to the artist and, you know, figure out what is appealing about the song. So I would just ask that we could keep the energy in the comments chill, you know, keep it respectful. And with that out of the way, let's get into it. This is Chlorophyll by HYD. Eventually it will be. There we go.
I broke the contract. Ropes couldn't hold me back tonight. Your ties can't keep me from myself. Am I to blame? No home, no collar. I left you unleashed by the road. Your needs can't fix
me to the floor.
Am I to blame?
Yeah, I know that you don't know.
All right, I really like her. I found this the pathway for anybody. Maybe she watches this. The pathway for me to find this artist was I like Sophie, so then I found the AG Cook album, Apple vs 7G, the remix album. On that album, there's a remix by Umru, who I decided I really liked. So then I started checking out Umru, and there's an Umru remix of a HYD song. And then I thought, well, I should check out the original to see if I like it. So that is several steps of music exploration to get here. And I'm pretty happy with it. I like this. So to me, as somebody who doesn't listen to a lot of grunge, frankly, this song feels partially inspired by like early 90s. I'm thinking like Pixies, Smashing Pumpkins, maybe Nirvana. I don't really know very much Nirvana, so you know, but the very quiet sort of really stripped down verses, and then you sort of build it up into the chorus, and you drop it back down into that really stripped down verse. I really like that. I think it's effective. I like the way the chord changes happen. The vocal transitions, they don't always resolve the way you are expecting, which is like, look, this is, you know, on the face, this is sort of straightforward pop / hyperpop. If you look at some of the other songs on this original album, you will see like production by A.G. Cook and Sophie and other other prominent sort of hyperpop artists or PC music artists. And so you do get that very specific sort of, you know, the hyper auto-tune, the really saccharine, really sugary sort of up-toned vocals. But it's creative, and it is not a straightforward pop song where it always resolves the way you anticipate, which I think is worth noting. There is a lot of pop music that follows the same formula, and this mostly follows the same formula but deviates in ways that make it more interesting and more more complicated. I personally tend to enjoy music that is more complex. Not always, you know, I don't only listen to math metal or whatever, but I do tend to like music that is less predictable and forces me to engage with the song a little bit more. And I think that it's not just in this song. I picked the song today that I hadn't listened to, but I did listen to a few songs last night, and that's sort of part of the package. So I'm a fan. I really enjoy this. I will probably do more in the future. They maybe won't all be unlistened to. You know, I do generally try to do videos of songs that I haven't heard, because I think that is a more fair reaction. But I also want to go listen to this album. So, you know, there's a good chance that I will do more more songs, more videos, and I maybe will know, or at least have heard some of them already. As far as the video goes, I mean, there's not a whole lot to say. You know, it's kind of cool, right? You got the little equalizer line that goes crazy in the chorus. But, I mean, at the end of the day, she's sitting on an air pump, you know. Again, not that it's not effective, just that there's not a whole lot to really comment on. You know, she's sitting on there, she takes off the sunglasses, and she's got the eye black on underneath. And then at the end, she's swinging the nozzle, the hose, air hose around. You know, I will probably do another video just to see what a more fleshed out video looks like. I got no problem with people shooting low budget videos. I got no problem with people shooting minimalistic videos, but there's just not a lot of storytelling. I will say, in the first verse, talks about leaving someone, possibly, but you know, maybe a pet, right? Somebody with no collar by the side of the road. And so, you know, that sort of ties in thematically to the gas station air station. There should be a name for that. I don't know what it is. Anyway, the place you pump up your tires. So I guess that's connected. But again, it's not particularly high concept. And that's fine. But I do want to see what a more fleshed out conceptual video looks like. So we'll get into that. But for now, I'm happy. I like this. I think she's got a good voice, both unprocessed or mildly processed. And when, you know, they throw in the auto-tune to double it or, you know, pitch it up. Because although I did grow up in the era of people making fun of T-Pain for auto-tune is a tool and an instrument. And if you use it right, you can make it sound really interesting, right? If you overuse it in a way that is obvious, it becomes just another way to manipulate a voice, as opposed to an obvious attempt to cover up somebody's inability to hit a certain note. So I like it. I think hyperpop is the future, to be honest. You had the 90s where it was all, you know, guitars, pretty much. And then you had the 2000s and the 2010s where you started to get into EDM. Certainly in the 2010s, you know, the Chainsmokers were producing everybody. Selena Gomez, Ariana Grande, they're all doing music with EDM background instead of guitar. And now I think you're seeing a shift as we get, you know, Sophie and 100 Gex and A.G. Cook, these other hyperpop, Charlie XCX, right? Charlie XCX, huge right now, right? Big deal in pop culture. Maybe not the most successful artist, but once you get that unique sound that people start to enjoy, it starts to filter in to other music. So I think Dylan Brady is going to be a huge producer in the next few years. I think A.G. Cook is probably going to be a big deal in the next few years as this more mainstream pop music starts to adopt hyperpop and sort of hyperpop aesthetics. That's just my theory. We'll see what happens. But I hope it does, because it makes the music more interesting. And I'm all about that. I'm going to wrap it up here, though. Thank you guys for watching. Have a good day. Stay safe out there. Be good to each other. And don't talk to cops.